G'day viewers, I've got some projects here. Got a fax machine from our neighbours. Just got the power supply out because it went through a power spike. And it just died completely, so I'm in the process of trying to either find a whole complete new replacement power supply or just see if it's repairable. And I got another project. An AWA Radiola model 467MA. Here's a reference book to it. Technical information and service data. And there's another table and circuit codes, like all the component list, and the other technical mechanical information for this radio is in another book, which is pretty much the same radio as that, but doesn't have an indoor AM antenna. This one, model 449MA, is a reference book for this radio, which is this model here that I've got here. The only thing wrong with it, it's missing a knob, so I'm going to have to track down a knob for this. It's got everything I need to know. How the dial cord winds up, how to wire the transformer. This has already got an earth cord, it's a cloth cord, Australian made cord, it's all pretty well in good nick. Now let's look inside this radio, I've already got the back taken off. It's all pretty clean, other than just dust. So yeah, there it is. No rust, nothing. It's got a 6BE6, that's the rectifier. Hang on, that's the converter, I think, and that's the oscillator, which is a Brymar 6AE6. That one's the audio output, AWA Radiotron. The book tells me what it is, but I'll look at that later on. And that's the rectifier tube, another AWA Radiotron. The book also tells you what tube number that is. Speaker cone's in good nick, although it's a funny colour, but it's in good nick. I've got all the replacement parts in stock, except for these two 24 microfarad electrolytics. So I'll bunch my last 4 8 microfarads to replace that one. But I've only got a 33 that could replace that one. It might still work fine if I go higher in microfarad, but we'll see. It's got these paper wax caps, which are not wax, they're just paper and not sealed, so they're almost certainly going to be bad. There's your mica, they're your sealed paper wax caps. So that looks like it's been modified there, but yeah, that's all original. This is untouched, although that does look like it's been done before. And there, I think these are the IF can caps. There's no caps put in these IF cans. So yeah. Okay, viewers, I'm starting to get these capacitors replaced now. I've got a 24 microfarad replacement. Got plenty of these in stock, so got a whole bag I ordered. So yeah, it's lasted me a while, so yeah, that's a replacement for this lot. And I got a 33 microfarad to replace a 24 microfarad, because that's all I got left over, 1/8 microfarad left. So that should be okay, providing a too high a microfarad doesn't surge the tube too hard. So I don't think it's that too far out of tolerance. So hopefully we should be fine with that. I've got my replacements, some 0.1s and some 0.047s to replace most of those in here, like them ones and that one, which are just plastic tube with cotton stuffed in the ends. So they're paper caps but sealed with a plastic tube and just cotton on the ends, or some sort of plaster, I don't know what it is, but either way, almost certain to be done bad, so let's get replacing these caps. Okay, viewers, everything's right way up. I actually thought they installed these backwards, and I went to the just suspecting. Hang on. So I went and played back my video and spotted these wearing backwards, so I quickly fixed that problem up. So that was lucky. Yeah, it's actually been put the right way now. I replaced the two bad, most suspected caps. Now I'm going to just give it a quick power up to see if it does actually do anything. Alright, let's get this plugged in. Let's flip it back down here. Get this out of the way. And we'll flip it down and see if she actually flip it on the side here, see if I can get it to. Yeah, very carefully. Got the power on this way. Alright. Very carefully here, so I can see under the chassis if anything goes wrong. Plug it in, it should work, because they're the most suspected caps that would go bad apart from them ones. So let's see what happens. Not really much. Those caps do actually go bad very easily, so now that I've checked that, plug the soldering iron back in. That means I've got some caps around the audio and the radio part of the circuit to replace. Okay, viewers, all the caps have been replaced. No shorts. That's good. Just checking out, double check everything. That's good, that's a good connection. No shorts in there, that's good. I think we're about good to go. Alright. Okay. Clamp it up. Should start to work now. Audio valve comes on first.
The weekday wind down.
Weekday wind down.
There we go, we're working.
1467.
Needs a bit of a clean in the contacts, which is working. So this isn't a very well performing set, so, but still a valuable collectible overall. That's good lubricating. Can't get much out of the station to see what he had in the antenna. So I reckon the might need a little bit of a clean. Those are the original valves too, by the way. Find your bass. And it fades out as I turn it off. That's what I like about old radios. I think this little trimmer here might need a bit of an adjustment to get the dial to line up and get it to pick up strong, but other than that, I think she's good. I'm just going to give it an overall clean now, cosmetically, so the valves look nice and shiny. So yeah, you see that valve there is not even put in properly, it's just been pushed. So someone must have stuck their finger through the hole here as I was carrying it and pushed the valve. Yeah, the way it's the original valve, so it's not very loud either, so that valve could also be weak, but yeah. Just going to give it all a good clean, and I'll put it back together. Once I give this casing a good wash and some water. It's a bit, Yeah, dirty. So yeah, let's give it a clean, see how she looks after that. Okay, Villas, I'm going to start from this side and work my way, clean the valves. Now, something I forgot to mention, which is blamably obvious if you take notice, this is a 4-valve set. It's one of the first radios in my collection that is a 4-valve only. But yeah, I'm going to start from here, work my way and just polish the valves, but be very careful not to smudge the writing off. That one there, it does tell me what the book old valve to read it wants to take it out. There's a rectifier there, 6X4. You can see it on the side of that one. 6BV7, that's the audio output. So it's a fairly modern setup how all the pins and everything are, so let's just polish this one here up. It's a method of spirits, we're going to very carefully polish up this valve, so yeah. Okay, viewers, I've polished up the valves. In case you're wondering, AWA stands for Amalgamated Wireless Australasia, which means Australia and New Zealand. Prior to that, they were Amalgamated Wireless Limited. They were just based in Australia alone. They were a small company. I think Marconi or someone like that started the company off. They came to Australia and there was some TV or radio company with a phone company, and they decided to merge and they became amalgamated. So it was actually mainly about radios, Marconi's invention, marketing radios in Australia. So it became Amalgamated Wireless, and it was limited, so a single company. It's only based in a certain, only Australia alone. So they were Amalgamated Wireless Limited for a while, and I think sometime in the 1940s, I'm pretty sure, or maybe even earlier, 1930s or something like that, they became Amalgamated Wireless Australasia, because they were marketed in New Zealand as well. The whole of, Australasia, which is Australia and New Zealand combined. So they became Amalgamated Wireless Australasia. But yeah, this Brymar valve tends to smudge very easily, those British valves. So I've had to rewrite it with a texter 6AE6 on the valve. So yeah. So this is probably a good example of when AWA started cutting their costs to put cheaper sockets. And had, instead of sitting the transformer upright on its base on top of the chassis, it's mounted into the chassis like this, as you see. So, had to cut some jobs and quicken up their manufacturing process. But it is a highly sought after radio, so polished up the casing, just gave it all a good polish, the back and the front. And be very careful when you're polishing these dials. I've actually done some research on this prior to cleaning this. That paint will smudge off from the back. So be very careful when you're cleaning these dial fascias. So yeah, I'll put it back together and give you another demonstration. Okay, viewers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 caps all together. And they're going to make a big explosion if I pop them once. Anyway, I might just set them aside for now. And that's the finished product. But it doesn't look quite as good without that third knob. So I'm going to have to eventually chase up a knob to replace it. So yeah, let's turn it on. Now this model radio does look very good in the dark. Oh, and it's contact cleaner. So it's supposed to be spot on there, but the dial's probably drifted off the fascia about, probably about 5 millimetres, so it's a tiny bit off the dial line, but not too bad. But yeah, that volume control's very intermittent. I've got to get that and this. Yeah, I've got to get the tone control, a knob for that, clean that out with some contact cleaner, and the volume control, because it needs a lot of attention. Not so bad now, but at a certain point it will crackle and just, yeah, stop. So I've got to get that contact clean, let's try some other stations here. Oh yeah, it's got some hum bad. Yeah, get your contact cleaner in here.
News at 5 o'clock. Joe Cocker.
Before I tune any more stations in, I'm gonna see my antenna. Yeah, it doesn't even work. The internal antenna is pretty good. It looks like my save. That station now usually get reception on other radios, but just can't pick it up, so the valves could be weak. Yeah, need those valves to be weak, I would say.
True story. I think this is a real one on SMS.
Kicked
the border collie, had a bowl of milk at the bar, sitting on his stool on Sunday.
Yeah, a bit
intermittent there, but I could let it get clean. Very busy over the long weekend, especially with increase. Because of the, a lot of the airlines have
pulled
the plane to the ash cloud.
Since
it's shifted away.
Yeah, turn it back good when I touch it. Now what I'm going to contact clean these controls and put a tiny bit of silicon spray just to give them a good catch up, see how they work. Okay, if you also, it doesn't say in this manual, not that I know of, what year this radio was made. I think it was 1955 or 56. But could be in 1954 or thereabouts if I'm mistaken, but yeah. I'm trying to find a date here. Okay, not here. Maybe this model will have it. No date. Okay. But yeah. Other than having the books of these radios, it's bloody handy. I'm pretty sure it's from 1954, but yeah, the contacts have been cleaned and lubricated. Let's give it a test. Yeah, I've got a fun replacement knob. That's not looking good, and it's hard to use without a knob. Left the tuning around. That should work out and become less noisy after a while, so just gotta fiddle it. It will take some time, but yeah, once that quietens down, it'll be a lot better. Tuning's easy, that'll lubricate everything. This main shaft was stiff.
Your opposition leader Tony Abbott seized on that.
Does the Prime Minister agree with her resources minister that, and I quote, no one can rule out a mine or two closing because of the government's carbon tax?
Julia Gillard
cannot
says
find an antenna here.
Is expanding. The resources industry has a very bright future.
I've got an alligator clip somewhere. There you go, over there in that cluster. This does somewhat work as a swap-out retrofit for another car cluster too. The actual TACA will work. I'll demonstrate that in another video though. So this must be ABC radio here.
Yeah? In Malaysia. His question how the government can keep the promise that people sent to Malaysia would be exempt from Malaysian laws which allow caning.
This model does not have very good time.
Human beings, they go to roam around Malaysia for the rest of their days with a tag around their neck. What this government is proposing is that this tag, this talisman, will somehow protect these boat people indefinitely from the rigours of the Malaysian penal system.
Very nice.
The coalition's policy of sending asylum seekers to Nauru was inhumane and caused mental health problems.
They did not break the...
Right there, tunes in better with an antenna. Your 527 MA is a bit like this, but it's very weak, so I think the valves on my 527 MA might be weak as well. South Australia, town down that way is working. My STC radio did, the previous radio did, doesn't pick this up. So I think either the allotment might be out or the valves are weak on that as well, so that needs a big antenna to pick stuff up. But I'll do another video on that another day. Scratch that dial after you paint that and make it look normal again. Yeah, that's our radiola complete and repaired. Just needs a knob and it's all done. Same size as that. A gold finish in the middle of it. So I think this set was also worked on previously because these look to have been replaced, but the radio just hummed. They never replaced those or those. And this cord was put on there by the previous repairer, but other than that, it's all back how it should be. So it's got an earth, which means this earth here is redundant. Don't need this cord anymore. But normally that would just hook up somewhere on your mantle, on a metal part, and earth that way. But nowadays, you don't need that, you just got the earth in here. Enjoy the classics on this radio, so thanks for watching.